This is an original poster from about 1930, advertising the world-renowned magician, the Mysterious Smith. The poster was not always in this good a shape. Take a look.
Wag. It's got a center fold, and also a vertical fold. It's got rips and damage on it. We're gonna linen back it.
This poster is the standard US one-sheet format, which measures about 27 inches by 41 inches, and it's got the standard folio folds, as all posters of that time were folded and distributed from the printer folded.
Mysterious Smith in person, the Temple of Mystery. Do you believe in spirits? I do. At times.
Albert P. Smith. He was born in 1878 and died in 1957. And he was a showman during the 1920s and 1930s as the Mysterious Smith. Smith emigrated to the United States from France while he was a young boy. His name was Cantor, but he wanted to have an American-sounding name, so he chose Smith, as it appeared to be the most typical. I'm laying down the poster onto the wheat paste, and I'm stretching it out so that it expands as it absorbs the wheat paste. I have to add more moisture to it to get it to expand more and stretch it out more before I begin rolling. Smith had highly successful years between 1894 and 1899 when the Spanish-American War broke out. He entered the service and spent 2 years in the Philippines. In 1902, after getting out of the service, he began a tour as the magician and illusionist Mysterious Smith. He toured around the world to Japan, China, across India, and back to the Philippines. As you can see, we leave the rolling out of the edges for last. Got to get the last bits of wheat paste out of there and make sure there are no air pockets before we wash it off with the sponges. The magician, the illusionist. After coming back to the United States, he played in moderate-sized towns for a week at a time. His publicity stunt was a coffin escape. His wife and chief assistant, as Madame Olga, did a mentalism act in the show. By 1922, Smith was advertising as the show with the 25-year reputation, Mysterious Smith Company, with a carload of equipment and large company of assistants. One of his featured publicity stunts was a combined straitjacket and coffin escape.
We're going to let this dry for a few days before we restore it and trim it down. Mysterious Smith.
It's important that when we perform restoration on a poster that we use materials that are water-based, such as methyl cellulose, which is our glue for putting in paper fills, and our paper pulp mixture, which is methyl cellulose and paper powder, and our colors, which are water-reversible water-based watercolor markers, pencils, as well as gouache. We are burnishing. This is a way of flattening out the ridges and creases in the paper, and must be done before we touch it up.
If you have color mixed up, just put some color. Yeah, you can touch it up. Not the whole letter, just put a few spots of color on the dirt. That's printer. That's part of. That's in the plate. You don't have to fix that. Just touch up this.
Retired around 1935 to become a photographer and sold his show to Howard Thurston's brother, Harry Thurston. He did perform again after retirement in Iowa with an act called The White Prophet, Do Spirits Return?, which featured a spirit cabinet. The mysterious Smith's last performance was in Nashville, Tennessee in 1942. He had done in his lifetime 28,800 public performances in 42 states and traveled around the world twice. He died in 1957 in St. Petersburg, Florida. Thank you. By preserving this poster, I hope that we have also helped preserve the memory of the triumphant career of the mysterious Smith. After 30 years in business, at Poster Fix, we still look forward to seeing your posters.